Hey Equippers kids, and welcome to week two of the Backwards Kingdom. Now there is no better way to start off our service but other than with the prayer tent.
We love the prayer tent and we loved kicking it off with you last week at home.
Yeah.
So we're going to pray again today, and
so
today
good.
There are two things that are a bit different we want to pray for.
Cool.
The first one is all of our frontline workers.
Yeah.
So you might have known while we've been at home, there's been amazing nurses and doctors, firefighters, police officers,
yeah.
The people at your local supermarkets, pharmacies, who are still working to look after us.
Yeah.
And we want to pray that God would provide for them, He would cover
Come
them,
on.
Give their family favor. They're
so
more
good.
Exposed to the potential of catching
they
the virus
are, yeah.
than we are. So we need to pray for God's covering. So wherever you are, would you stand with us as we pray for all of our frontline workers? Let's pray
awesome.
Together, guys. Thank you, Lord. Lord God, we thank you, Jesus, that you're a God who covers. Holy Spirit, we invite you, Jesus, to bless every single frontline worker who's out there putting themselves in essentially harm's way to look after us. They're bold, they're courageous, and we honor them for
yes,
it. So
Jesus.
Holy Spirit, we pray, Lord Jesus, for their sacrifice, that you would come through with favor and provision, that you would protect
yeah.
them and their families.
Yes,
Lord God,
God,
we thank you, Jesus, for their service, and we pray that they feel a sense of your peace,
yeah.
a sense of your joy as they go into the work ahead, the week ahead, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, Josh, we've got one more thing we need to pray for before we get started.
We do, and that is salvation. I don't know about you, but I am so thankful for my yeah. salvation, and it's so important that we make it personal all the time. So there's something we say at Equippers that I want to encourage you to do today, is that think of someone who's close to you but far from God, and what we're going to do is
yeah.
we're going to pray that
Thank
God
you,
would
Lord.
Encounter them right where they're at in the everyday life. Even today, as we stream on a Sunday and you share it with them, would they watch this and encounter God in
Great.
A whole new way? And so we're going to pray for that person that you're thought of.
Thank you,
All right,
Lord.
God, we thank you right now, God, for every person,
yeah.
Lord, that has been named, Lord, that has been thought of. And we declare that today is the day of salvation.
Great.
God, it doesn't matter what we've done, how far away we think we are from you.
Thank
God,
you, Lord.
You are, Lord, only a question away. God, only a hand away. And
Good.
So, God, we ask that you would reach and touch every one of those people, God, that
right.
you would, Lord, shift the trajectory of their life,
Good.
God, and they would encounter a living and loving God
right.
today,
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, and would live in relationship with you for the rest of their lives, in Jesus' name,
amen.
Hey
guys, well, we are loving seeing all of your bubble photos that you're
we
sending
sure
us.
Are.
So keep them coming through. Remember, as we prophesy, just like when we blow up a bubble, God's Spirit lifts it up and then the membrane pops and releases that prophetic word
yeah.
over a person or a situation.
So good.
Keep praying, keep tagging
yeah.
us with your hashtag popping prayers. We're going to establish a pop culture
That's
in
the
New
one.
Zealand and across the world. We'll see you soon. Bye guys.
See ya.
Equippers kids, and welcome to week two of the Backwards Kingdom. Here's Josh, who's been practicing this move all week for you.
All
Josh,
week.
Josh, let's see this upside down handstand.
Oh,
wow!
Yeah.
Wow! Give him a round of applause. That
Thank
was
you.
Great. How about you give it a go at home, not too close to the TV. But hey, if you don't know us, my name is Michelle and this is Josh.
Hey,
and
hey.
We are so excited to be your MCs for today.
Come on.
So Josh, can you tell
yes.
us, do we have any notices for our kids at home today?
Well, we do. There is something that happened last week.
There sure
and that
is.
Was called the Boom Zoom Party.
Woo-hoo!
And if you're with us, you're gonna see yourself in a video real soon. And if you weren't, make sure you join us at the end of every series. We're gonna have one of these. It's where we get to come together, have a whole lot of games,
Absolutely.
Get to hang out, you guys get to dress up. There's a prize for the best dress, the whole lot. It's a whole lot of fun. So we're gonna watch a video on that right now. So see if you
Enjoy
can spot
it.
Yourself.
Come on, let's go. Breaking up. I'm breaking up in every tide of mind. Your love is breathing out into my life. You take my burden and you make it light. You make it light. Come on, bring the sound. Bringing a sound that would break the night. I choose to follow you for all my life. I know that you were always by my side. You're by my side.
Everything.
And everything we do, we choose to praise you. No matter
we're back. It's now time for the icebreaker.
Oh, I'm
and Michelle, I'm pretty competitive, so I hope you're ready for this. But what is going to happen is we have a whole lot of M&Ms here, one of my favorite sweet treats. And our challenge today is to split them as fast as we can
into
their colors, and
so,
I'm going to beat you.
Yes, we've been learning about how God does everything back to front. It's the backwards kingdom.
Yeah.
But we have to be discerning to figure out how it is that it's God's ways versus the world's ways.
Yeah.
So that's what we're about to do. We're about to discern all the different colors.
Come on.
I'm going to be representing all the women. Woo!
And I'm going to be representing all the winners, who are the guys. Here we go.
Okay, I'm ready.
3, 2, 1, go.
Oh my gosh. Okay, this is actually quite hard. Oh my goodness.
All right.
Green to the side.
I'm pretty confident here, guys.
Oh my goodness. Imagine if you were trying to play this colorblind, Josh. Oh.
That would be hard, wouldn't it?
Discerning all these colors. Girls, I need you to cheer for me because seriously.
Come on, boys. Keep it up.
Josh is very competitive. I want to beat him. Oh. My fingers are moving faster than they've ever moved.
Quick.
Yeah, I am. Doing it for the women of the world. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it's going in the wrong spot.
Hey, if you guys have some at home, you should join in with us.
You should. If you don't have M&Ms, maybe find some cereal, find some like rice bubbles and some cornflakes. They're not as nice as these, but it'll be so good to face your siblings.
I reckon whoever wins should get to eat them all, Josh.
You reckon?
Yep, because I'm pretty confident I've got it. Close.
Done.
Oh, man.
Come on.
I feel like you had less M&Ms.
Oh, I didn't put them down. So I win.
Oh,
awesome.
Man.
Good job.
That means Josh is going to be eating M&Ms for the next week. Sorry, girls.
Still have
I
my
promise
Easter eggs left.
I'll win for you next week. But hey, it's time for our favorite time of the service. Can you give us a drum roll?
Praise and worship!
Praise and worship! So how about you stand to your feet, make sure you've got lots of room in your lounge or your bedroom or wherever you are, so that you can dance and praise Jesus with us this morning.
Here we go.
We have an awesome surprise for you. This week we're going to be learning a new song by
good
our favorite band, Equippers.
Revolution.
That's the one. And hey, if you follow us on TikTok, you're probably going to know some of the moves to the Spirit Challenge.
Come on.
These ones here, we're going to be whipping those out as we dance together. So if you don't know the words yet, that's okay. Follow along as best you can. But hey, just lift up any praise at all.
So
God
good
loves to hear your voice. So let's tell the DJ to hit that track.
Let's go.
Clap your hands, everybody. Thank you, Lord.
When I found your love, you brought my world to life and opened up my eyes to see your heart for mine.
Back to our waves.
I thought I knew what freedom was, but now I know it's you.
Here comes our moves.
My heart.
Give Jesus a shout of praise. We thank you, God. We love you so much. Come on, wherever you are, whether you're in the lounge, your bedroom, I just encourage you right now that in this moment, God wants to come and touch your life. And if you're comfortable to do so, I just invite you to lift your hands.
King of glory, be lifted up, be enthroned upon our praise, seated high. Feel a stirring as we draw near. You are welcome in this place. We are open.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you, God.
Our hearts are ready. You are here to move.
We worship you, God.
Behold, the King is here. Heaven saturates this atmosphere. Miracles are taking place as we declare your name. Heaven is here. Heaven is here. Heaven is here.
God, we just thank you in the midst of chaos and uncertainty. God, you're here with us. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you this morning, God. We lift you up. You're so glorious, Jesus.
Feel your spirit calling me. I abandon all I know for what you hold. In your presence,
I just invite you to reach out. Come on, the Bible says that as we draw near to Him, He draws near to us. Thank you, Jesus, that you're going to meet us right where we're at. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. You're so good, God. Lord, we pray, God, that you would encounter us today. Holy Spirit, would you minister to each heart in this place, Jesus? Thank you, God.
I can't hold it again.
King is here. Heaven saturates this atmosphere. Miracles are taking place as we declare your name. Heaven is here. Heaven is here.
God, we just thank you right now that heaven is here, God. Whatever, Lord, wherever we are, whatever we're going through, God, Lord, in the mountaintops and in the valleys, you're with us. And so, God, I pray today, Lord, that your presence would meet us wherever we're at, God. Whatever we're needing in our hearts, God, I pray that you would touch that place. God, would you touch the place that only you can get to? And Holy Spirit, we pray that you would minister and, Lord, that you would change lives, Lord, and they would be changed forever in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen.
Hello, kids, and welcome back to our next session of our series, The Backwards Kingdom. If you missed it at the start, my name's Michelle, and it's my privilege to be teaching you this morning. Make sure your ears and your hearts are open to receive, because this content is good. So here we have it. If you missed last week, I'm gonna go over a few of the basics of what this series is about first to get us going. So I picked gymnasts. If you know anything about me, then you'll know that I love dancing. And just like Josh showed us at the start of today, they can do some pretty awesome tricks that are upside down and back to front. So this is kind of like the kingdom of God. We live life backwards, or a bit counterculture is another way that we can call it, to the rest of the world. We do things the kingdom way. So over here we have some pictures of some of the stuff that maybe some people choose to prioritize, like money or a career or traveling. And while those things aren't necessarily bad, it's when they start to become the only motivator of our life and get in the way of what really matters, which is the stuff that Jesus says matters in the Word of God. We have a picture here, you might recognize it from one of my favorite card games. It's from the game Uno, and it's the reverse one. So you might be going this way around your circle, but when you play that reverse card, you head back the other way. Jesus gives us an alternative way of looking at and living our lives. And we started unpacking last week one of the ways. Can you remember what it was? Oh, I think some of you got it right. It was religion versus relationship. So we looked at the way that the world sometimes looks at Christianity, like it's a bunch of rules. And Josh even shared with you some of the funny ones that they used to abide by in the Old Testament. They used to give animal sacrifices and even shave their hair. But we like to think of our faith as a relationship. That's really what Jesus wants to do, is just be your best friend. So we looked and talked about the fact that we don't just want to look like a Christian, but we want heart transformation, where we're motivated by coming under people, not judging people through a lens of rules, but by coming under to lift them up and to show them what it means to live in relationship with God and relationship with the community or family of Christ. And today, we're going to move on to another thing that Jesus does back to front. Can you give me a drum roll? I want to hear it. Very good drum roll, guys. It is wisdom. Can you all say wisdom in your loudest voice? And now I want to hear it in your quietest whisper. Very, very good. And if we jump back just two slides, we started talking about our series scripture last week, which says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord." And here's the interesting thing about wisdom. People in the normal world might think they know what it means, but God has a different definition. He has a higher definition for wisdom, and that's what we want to learn about today. So, maybe you've learned a few things about wisdom, like I said. You might have thought of an owl when I said the word wise. We like to use that as a symbol. Or maybe in some of the movies or cartoons that you might have grown up with, it's been represented maybe by a wizard or a smart kind of person that knows a lot of knowledge. Or maybe you thought about the word intelligent or smart, or if you were super clever, maybe the word discerning. Now, discernment is really what we want to hone in on today. Can you say that tricky word for me? Discernment. That's the one. Because it's actually the Holy Spirit that gives us discernment. And when we tap into that, we step out of thinking wisdom's like this, which it's really not, and knowing that it's discerning by the Spirit, kind of like our feelers going out by the Spirit to figure out what it is that God's saying to us, where He's leading us, what He's trying to teach us. It's kind of like spot the difference. There's a real version of wisdom and a fake one. If you look super closely at these pictures, you might be able to spot the difference. Can you discern what's different between SpongeBob here and SpongeBob here? You might have noticed a few things. The first one I noticed when I looked at it is that his symbol's different. You might not be able to see it on the camera, but over here there's an anchor, the one that he really has for his job. But this one's a snowflake. And over here he's got something on his plate, but he doesn't hear. Maybe you also noticed that the lid is a different color. We want to make sure today that we finish understanding how Jesus does wisdom back to front to the rest of the world. So let's first understand, what does the world think wisdom is? I have a question for you, and I want you to yell the answer back at the TV screen for me. So, who knows what Google is? I'm sure you all do. I'm sure some of you that are in primary or intermediate might be using Google Meet to meet with your teachers at the moment as well at home. I want to ask you, how many questions do you think people ask on Google every day? 3.5 is my only clue. Is it 3.5 thousand? Is it 3.5 million? You might not have guessed it, but it's 3.5 billion questions every single day. That's a huge number. And the thing is, it's because people are so desperate to learn and grow in their knowledge and their intelligence. People want this thing called wisdom. We're inquisitive. But there's a bit of a problem with worldly wisdom, and here I'll give you an example of what. Can you all tell me what your favorite flavor of ice cream is? Oh, I think I heard some chocolate, strawberry, goody goody gumdrops. But you might notice we don't all agree. And that's one of the main issues with worldly wisdom, is I might not think the same thing as Josh, and Josh might not think the same thing as Adriana. We all have different opinions. That's a bit of an issue when it comes to knowing what's right, what's true. You see, in the world, a lot of people ask others for expert advice, we might call it. Even our Prime Minister at the moment, you might have seen, she does lots of talks on the TV, and she often has the Health Minister or other people who have special areas of knowledge that help her to make her decisions. She has people that are advising her, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, unless the things that they're advising her are not the right things. There are two main ways that the media works. The media and the news know how humans are wired. They know how to get our attention. One of them, if you can read this word, is desire. They want to make us want something or need something, and that's how they get our attention. Or They want to make us afraid or scared, and that's how they get our attention. We want to make sure as Christians that that's not the lens or the guise through which we're getting attention or trying to give out information to the world. We want to make sure that it's coming through, go little pointer, the Word of God. So here it says, John 14:6, and I want you to read it along with me, because we're not going to make people scared, or we're not going to put something false in front of them to get their attention. We're just going to offer them the truth. It says, Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Isn't that cool? That God actually calls himself truth. He is honest and firm and sure. And if we go back here, that's the problem with us. We're not. We have a lot of what we call frailty. It's kind of like if you had a pot and maybe it had a crack or two in it. And it doesn't mean we're any less valuable or worthy to God. It just means that we have a few imperfections perhaps. So maybe we slip over, we trip up. Maybe sometimes we accidentally tell a little white lie or make a mistake or cheat on our test. We're not always perfect and we don't always know the right answers. In fact, you might find it funny to know that we actually used to think that the world was flat. Then suddenly we realized it's not flat, it's a circle. Another thing we believed for a long time was that Pluto was actually a planet. Now we know it's just a rock. There are lots of things that humans think we know, and then we realize we actually haven't discovered the half of it. It's kind of like this. We've got to think about who we're listening to, and I'm going to tell you a bit of an embarrassing story about Michelle. I was not listening to good wisdom when I was your age. I went to these pools in Hamilton, and you might see here, there's lots of tiers or levels of diving boards. Now, Michelle's a great dancer, but she's not a very good diver. I had never dived before in my life, and I thought, oh, I really want to look cool for my friends, and my friends were saying, that's a great idea, Michelle. Don't go from level one, go straight to level 5 on the diving board. And I thought, yes, my friends really want to see me do this. So up I went, up the ladder, up, 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 all the way to the top, and I looked down, it was pretty high. Now, I don't really know how to dive, so I did the classic pin drop. Maybe you've done it before, except it was so far down that Michelle did not hit the floor, or the floor, glad I didn't hit the floor. I didn't hit the water with my toes, I hit it with my bottom. I was winded and floundering in the water. The lifeguard had to come and get me. It was so embarrassing. And the worst part about it is that my entire butt was bruised for 2 weeks long, all because I listened to the wrong wisdom, the wrong advice. And the thing is, when we have too many voices in our head, we start to get confused and lost. It gets unclear. But God is not unclear. We know that God's Spirit is not confusing, and when we listen to Him, He makes the path straight and the way obvious. We don't want to be around people who change their mind or make mistakes. We want to have a sure thing, and our sure thing is Jesus. There's this amazing story in the Bible. You can actually find it twice. And we know that if Jesus puts something in the Bible more than once, He's trying to make a point. Both Luke and Matthew wrote about this story, about what we build our foundations on. So that means what you build your life on. So I have two photos here. One of them is of palm trees weathering a pretty hefty storm. They're being blown over, but they're not uprooted. They're still standing strong. They've got a good foundation. And over here, you might have seen, uh-oh, this tree got uprooted and it has flattened that car. With godly wisdom, we can be sure that it's true and firm when we ground ourselves in it. It's like the story. We don't want to build our life upon the sand. We want to build it upon the rock. And maybe if you're a little bit younger, you might know the story of the three little pigs. Their story is very similar too. They choose three different things to build their houses out of. But we know that when the wolf comes and blows, the wolf is kind of like the devil or the challenges or the issues or problems or challenges that we face. When they blow two of those pigs, their houses collapse. But the one that built on the brick is the one that keeps standing. God never misses. He's always the same. He was the same 2,000 years ago as he is today. And we can be sure that when we read his word, when we build our lives upon the promises that are in his scripture, there's no changing what he said for our lives. So that's all good to know. It's good to understand worldly wisdom, which is perhaps listening to too many voices that are confusing, or trying to pursue knowledge for the wrong reasons and getting a little bit lost or overwhelmed. But then there's one voice that makes things clear, makes things sure for us, that we can build a secure foundation for our lives upon, and that is godly wisdom. But how do we get it? It's no good if we don't know how to get it. I've got some ideas for you, and they're very easy and accessible to you wherever you are in your life. So if we want to actually apply godly wisdom, the best place we can go is to our Bible. It's like a treasure map. I'm sure many of you love doing scavenger hunts at home. It's like that. We search through it for the treasure. There's always treasure for everything that we're facing. Maybe there have been a few arguments or upsets at home over the last few weeks. There's treasure in the Bible that can tell you how to love your family better, to help restore things at home. Or maybe you've been feeling really lonely. There's treasure in the Bible that can help you to know that God is with you. He loves you. He's your best friend. There is no one in the world that he would rather hang out with than you. It's such a little gold mine. Read your Bible. And then the other thing is prayer. We can pray and talk to God. We've been doing this in our Worship Wednesday sessions, talking about how important it is to have a constant conversation with God. He wants to hear about everything in your day. And it's not just us talking to him. He wants to talk back to us. So make sure that you spend time as well, sitting there and opening your ears to listen. He's going to speak and reveal that godly wisdom to you. And there's one other thing we can do. While we don't want to, like Michelle did on the diving board, listen to the wrong voices that end up getting us into trouble or into bad situations, we want to listen to the right people. And it's okay to ask for help. I put this little marker here upside down because actually in the world today, it's not really looked upon as a good thing to ask for help, but it is the best thing that you can do. There is no better thing that you can do in everything in your life than to access the awesome parents perhaps that you have, or perhaps the awesome leaders that you have, or perhaps the awesome teachers that you have. We want to make sure we do things opposite to the world. We know the Bible is worth reading. We know prayer is worth pursuing. And we know that asking for help when we need it is the best thing that we could possibly do, because there are people that have just walked with God a little bit longer. Maybe they've heard him through some situations that they've faced in their life that now you're struggling with, and they could give you some of that godly advice to help you through it as well. So that's what we wanted to learn about today. Week one, we did religion versus relationship. And this week we've talked about worldly wisdom versus godly wisdom, and making sure that it's God's voice that's directing us, and understanding how it is that we can access that voice. So as we wrap up, there's just two groups of people that I'd love to pray for this morning. Perhaps you're out there and maybe you've never heard Michelle speak before, or you've never even been to a church environment, even just church at home on your TV. And you're going, that sounds great, Michelle. I don't just want to have to Google things. I don't want to talk to my friends who don't know Jesus. I want to know the source of the best wisdom and guidance for my life. Someone sure that I can build my foundations upon. I want to introduce you to my best friend who wants to be your best friend. And his name is Jesus. So how about we all close our eyes, and kids, if you're out there and you've already given your hearts to Jesus, can you pray with me and believe in faith for all the children across the world that are going to give their hearts to Jesus this morning for the first time? Let's pray together. Thank you, Jesus, that you met with me today. I thank you, God, that you want to teach me how to live my best life. I want to be able to hear you. So can you please forgive me of my sins? Can you make a home in my heart? I love you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. give a huge round of applause for all of those people who just chose to make Jesus their best friend as well. I can't wait to hear all of the wisdom and revelation that he downloads to you. But hey, there's one more thing I want to pray for. Perhaps you're out there and you've actually known Jesus for a long time, but for whatever reason, you're feeling a little bit distant, or God's feeling a bit distant, and you're not able to hear him in the same way you used to. I want to pray that today, whatever blockage there is there in the spirit, that God would supernaturally remove it so that we can have access to the person that wants to give us all the knowledge, all the direction, and all the friendship, love, and compassion we could ever want and need. So if that's you, we open our hands like this when we pray to receive. And I believe as you open your hands the same way you'd reach up to mum or dad for a hug like this, we reach out saying, God, I'm in need of you this morning. So God, we pray for every child that said today, God, I want more of you. I want to hear you. I want to be able to access you. God, we pray for whatever spirit that might be causing isolation. Maybe they've decided to adopt an orphan spirit or a rejection spirit. We cut it off in Jesus' name. And we replace it with a firm understanding of whose they are. We thank you, God, that they belong to you, that your voice is going to be clearer in the next week than it's been in years. We thank you, God, for children that walk their lives hand in hand with you, hearing the voice of your spirit and obeying it. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh my goodness. Well, I had so much fun with you, but hey, we're going to pause for a second because I gave you a few ideas, but I actually have some friends, some kids that I love that are going to share with you how it is that they connect with Jesus. Turn your eyes to the screen.
Hi, I'm Zane. I'm 12 years old, and I'm from Equipers Church in Monaco, and I hope you're having a good Sunday.
Awesome, Zane. So can you tell us how you hear God's voice?
I hear God's voice when I'm quiet, when I'm reading my Bible, and just praying to God. But when you're praying to God, it's not just talking to God. It's also God talking to you.
Cool. Can you think about a time that God spoke to you?
Yeah. When we moved to Auckland, I didn't want to move to Auckland. I wanted to stay in Napier with my friends. But we moved to Auckland, and The night before school started, I was really nervous and anxious. I just prayed to God, and God said to me, everything's going to be fine. You're going to make lots of friends, and you're just going to have a good day.
Cool. So how do you know it's God speaking to you?
I know it's God speaking to me because there's a verse in the Bible that goes, faith comes by hearing, and hearing comes by the word of God. And when you read your Bible, the closer you're going to get to hearing God and really communicating with him.
Hi, I hope you're all doing well in lockdown. And one way that I know that it's God is because I can feel the Holy Spirit's presence around me, and I always get goosebumps whenever the Holy Spirit is around me. So I tune into God and I always hear what he has to say for me. And how I know it's God is because he has such a calming and gentle and relaxing voice, and he's very supportive and encouraging. And that's how I hear God. Bye.
Well, thank you so much to our friends Zane and Moirangi for sharing their wisdom that God's deposited in their hearts. There's one more group of people that would love to say hello to you. We started this thing called the Teacher Feature, and last week we had Adriana and Larissa and Caleb checking in to tell you how much they loved and missed you. But we know we have people from all over the country and all over the world joining us. So we have some of our other kids' pastors here this morning to check in and tell you hello.
Hey guys, it's Maya here. Hope you're having an amazing week so far. Big shout out to all my kids from Equipers Pukekohe. I miss you guys so much and I can't wait to see you. Bye.
Hi friends, it's Abby here. I can't wait to see you all again. Your leaders and I, we miss you guys so much, and we are praying for you guys all the time. We really hope that you're having fun in your bubbles, hanging out with your family, even enjoying working hard on that schoolwork. But we just want you to know that we love you and we believe in you, and we really look forward to hanging out again soon.
Kia ora, Equipers kids, and a special shout out to my kids at Equipers Monaco. It's Hope here. I just wanted to pop in really quickly and say how much I've been missing seeing you guys while we've been at home. Of course, I've been having lots of fun at home with my family. We've been doing lots of crafts and games and cooking, and I hope you guys have been having fun with your families too. But that doesn't take away from the fact that I've really missed seeing you guys on Sunday. So I just wanted to say that I've been thinking about you, I've been praying for you, and I can't wait until we can be together again. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.
Hey guys, what an awesome word by Michelle about applying godly wisdom and also not to jump straight off the fifth diving board and get a bruised butt. I'm going to learn my lesson from that one this summer. Awesome, but we're about to head into our e-groups and our craft. So make sure that you pause this video and you go on to our next ones. We'll see you there.